brief press conference, and that too on a very short notice. You must have witnessed that there have been some rounds of talks already at various levels with the employees of the Power Development Department, who have gone on an indefinite strike. And just few hours back also, we were there discussing the issues over with them. The press conference actually is to highlight certain points. I would just like to mention that the power sector reforms, they are inevitable. The government of India has clearly told us to ensure that the reformation is in place. Whatever funds and grants that are going to come now in the power sector are going to be linked with certain verifiable objective criteria and achievable parameters. The purpose and the intent is very simple. You are all aware, the Honorable Lieutenant Governor, UT of J&K, has also said that the goal is 24/7 power supply, and that too assured and quality power supply. So that is the only simple intent behind all these measures. You have yourself witnessed that today, in today's scenario, wherever there is power, there are DISCOMs, distribution companies, there are corporations, like we have the Power Distribution Corporation and the Power Transmission Corporation in Jammu as well as Kashmir province. We are supposed to move ahead towards a more accountable system, and we are not supposed to go back into ages. I assure you that the government is working with all the commitment and sincerity to protect public interest. Whatever actions have been taken till now or shall be taken would be to safeguard public safety, public health and public order. That is our prime intention. Meanwhile, if you have gone through some of the demands that have been raised by the union, they have mentioned that because of the unbundling, there have been certain disadvantages to them. I would like to bring forth the point that already it has been clarified, codified, and the government order issued in writing that none of the service condition, the pay structure, the salary, the pensionary benefits, none of it would be altered to the disadvantage of any of the employees of the Power Development Department. For last 24 months, everyone is regularly getting the salaries and all the emoluments. There might have been certain delays somewhere down the line, and the MD of the corporations have clearly told that a mechanism can be evolved to ensure that there is a hassle-free and a streamlined, timely payment system. So I think that always can be worked out. There was certain demand of regularization. For that also, there is already a mechanism of a qualifying criteria in place, and mechanism is already there. Meanwhile, the issues pertaining to the joint venture that has been there, already the government has agreed that it has been put to hold. There can be a working group to work out the further modalities for the same. So if you have yourself gauged, the government has already acceded to all the demands. And as we said during the briefing also, that was there a few hours back with the union leaders, certain policy related issues and service related issues, they cannot be decided off the cuff and orders issued on the spot. It requires some kind of a joint working group and some time frame to adjudicate and decide upon such matters. So I think the stand of the government is quite clear. We are going to take steps to safeguard the public interest. Right now, what is the power scenario? I would like the MD JPDCL to brief you what kind of outages we are facing at present and what are the modalities in place.